I want you to tell my people, tell them that they have the power, and that in the end times, which we are living in, there will be famine, there will be pestilence, which we see that already with the coronavirus. What does pestilence mean? It means an outbreak of sickness. It could be anything. Pestilence could be the flu. It could be something very simple. You know, it's an outbreak of a sickness, of a disease. And that's what we have right now in the world, not just in one little piece, not just in your little country, in your little city, but this is happening worldwide. We are living in the last days, but I want to encourage you what God showed me, that people will come to you because the doctors can't solve the coronavirus. The doctors can only put a band-aid and try to minimize it. They could try to do everything they could, but I want to tell you that Jesus Christ, the blood of Jesus, can rip and break every chain. I'm telling you guys, there are things that the doctors and that any doctor on this can tell and testify, no, we can't solve every sickness. All we can do is give you medications to alleviate the pain. They cannot solve cancer. They cannot solve these different things. And we must be the light that's going to shine in this world. We must stand up and rise up in the name of Jesus Christ. We must rise together, guys. So we must come together as a family of God, because I don't care if you're Baptist. I don't care if you're Pentecost. Guess what? In the Bible, Jesus doesn't say, oh, wait a minute. You're Catholic. I'm sorry. You can't come. No, he says, guess what? Pick up your cross and follow me. Those who are born again and saved till the end will come into heaven, will enter in the kingdom of heaven. This is a lifestyle, guys. The Lord showed me this is a lifestyle. You must live this as a lifestyle, not to be playing. This ain't no time to be playing games. God said, you know what? I want you to tell the church to rise up, because they're going to be, the world is going to be looking for answers. And guess what? They're not going to go. They already know the doctors can only do so much. What they're going to do, put a mask on you and then put you in quarantine you, and then close you in the doors. You know what they're going to do? They're going to look for the people who are on fire for God, and those who they know that have the anointing, the power. And that's you guys. You, not just me. This is for you. God says this is for every person who was a born again, saved to the bone Christian. You guys have the power. You have the power. You got the power. We got the power. And people are going to be looking for us for answers. They're going to be coming to us, their family members, their grandmothers, their grandparents, those, you know, those abuelas that know that there's power in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. You know what I'm talking about? They know that there is power. That was my grandma Licha. We must be the ones who are going to help people. You and me. Don't just speak it, but actually help people. And so there are many times that you will come across somebody in your church or a brother or sister in Christ, and they're going to need your help. Do not say no. We must bless one another. We must be here for one another. That's what the church is for. Jesus is the only reason. Jesus is the way to the Father. He said, the Father and me are. All right, guys, I want to tell you what the Lord was showing me, and I don't know if this is true. I'm not a prophet, guys, but I just want to tell you the things that he was showing me is the way possibilities of this famine is all of these people getting the coronavirus, all these people getting sick. It's not just a coronavirus. I feel like there's going to be another sickness that's going to come, another pestilence, another outbreak. And as they keep coming, as you can see, you're going to see, guys, that the world is going to be getting sick. So who's going to be working the fields? If the farmers are sick, who's going to be tending and doing all these things? Who's going to be bringing in food? Who's going to be working at the Walmart if the Walmart employees are all sick, right? I'm trying to give you an example of what's going to happen to come. So all these people are going to be sick. So what? Guess what? trucks can't get truck home slicko that's driving the truck trying to drive a truck with food. He's sick. I'm just giving an example. These are what God was showing me. All these people getting sick, nobody doing work, nobody able to do work. It's not because they don't want to, but they're not able to because they're sick. They're quarantined. They're being quarantined. Who's going to be doing that? Well, there's going to be famine. There's no food. We can't get food because all these people are sick. So that's the one thing the Lord was showing me. As the Lord was showing me that that's how there's going to be famine. Through the pestilence, through all these sickness outbreaks, because all these people can't do the work. So who gonna do the work? So I wanna encourage you guys to be wise in this, to be smart. I'm not telling you this to be scared. I'm not trying to put fear on you, because fear is not from God. That is from the devil. I wanna tell you this so that you're aware. Just like Jesus was trying to tell us about the end days, he wasn't trying to put fear on us. He was trying to give us wisdom and give us, allowing the Christians and the people to be aware that these are the signs of the times. Another thing I want you to encourage you is to fast regularly. Why do I say fast regularly? Not because I fasted. God was showing me, if you can't handle one day without food as a Christian, as a believer, how you gonna do it when all these sick, all the famine, there's no food in the world? How you gonna do it? That's what he was showing me, Carlos. He was like, Carlos, if you cannot handle one day, one or two days without having any food, how are you guys, you as Christians, gonna handle when there's a famine and when there's like no food at all? I remember Y2K, anybody been around in Y2K? When this was the year 2000, when it was gonna be January the 1st, it was back in December of 1999, right? And I remember everyone saying that because the computers were not going to be sufficing for the date. We go to the Walmart and they're all the grocery. Y'all ever been through like a hurricane and stuff? You go to the HEB or whatever grocery store and there is no bread, no water. Everything is gone like Chaka Khan. I mean, it's gone. It's gone. There's nothing available, right? So that's what the Lord was showing me. He's like, so this is what's going to happen. When all there's no famine, people are going to be rushing to the Walmarts and stocking up, right? So what you going to do if you boo-boo to foo-foo and you are not able to get there on time and you can't get there so quick, what you going to do? You going to just starve and you're going to die? No, man. If you are able to fast, if you're able to deny yourself, deny the flesh, then you will be strong. And we must do it as parents, right? Because we're the older ones. The adults should be able to do this. So what would we want to do? Naturally, you're probably going to want to feed your little home slickles, right? Your little kids, your little kiddos. I'll give my food to the kids, and I'll just fast and pray and ask for God to help us while we have no food for a while. So I want to encourage you to regularly maybe take a time out of each week, maybe every Monday, maybe every Tuesday, maybe every Wednesday, to fast and pray. So like as you get used to fasting and praying, you will be strong and you will not be hurting. As some people say, and y'all don't understand this, but my friends would say back at home, my second tripa is eating my other tripa. When you're so hungry and your stomach, you can hear your stomach growling, man, you hungry. And your other stomach is eating your other stomach. You're like, You don't want to be in that situation. But if you regularly fast and pray, at least take one day out of your week, you won't have this problem. You'll be strong in the spirit. You'll be okay. Can't nobody tell you nothing. All right? I love you guys in the name of Jesus. Be blessed. Y'all know I'm crazy. I'm going to tell you like it is. Be blessed. Tell the truth. Shame the devil. Love y'all.